Okay, we will start with sending in the infantry. 3 units of assault infantry will attack there, and 8 units of Waffen SS. They can all attack their rifleman unit there. They have a full rifleman unit of 80 men. And then the Stokes Mortars 21 will attack this bunker, and the other one, 24 crewmen, will attack the second bunker. We have a bunker here too. Alright, the general will not do anything. It's the BMV general. He will stay outside of the battle. So this is the same city as before. It's Minsk, or the large town of Minsk. Alright, and we have the army here on this side. Lots of infantry, which is perfect for rushing the bunkers. But can't take care of the planes inside, but we have lots of planes too. Problem is, we have a general, so it will probably get killed. Anyway, let's start the battle. Hopefully we can take back Minsk now. During the winter. Ah, the bunkers are taking out our infantry before they even reach the city. Ah, the infantry is defeated. Too bad, I shouldn't have sent them in. I should have first taken them out with the mortars. But the mortars have started to fire on the bunkers. They will be taken out. We have no army to send in after. So the other side, the army has reached this large town. Our planes are inside and fighting their planes. We have a clear numerical advantage this time in planes. Our infantry has also reached the outskirts of the city. I'm going to stop playing as both Isengard and Dunland in the campaign, in Lord of the Rings campaign, because it takes forever. So I will only play as Isengard and let AI control Dunland. I might give them back the 2 Dunlanding regions so they can do better as the AI, but Dunland is the weakest faction in Lord of the Rings Total War, so I might not do it. I might actually let them have only Dunyar their capital and keep the others for Isengard myself. Alright. So Minsk is about to be conquered. Balance of power. Victory is almost a certainty. Allies killed 5%. Enemies killed 4% currently. Yeah, we have a clear advantage. 9% enemies killed 5%. Allies killed 10% enemies killed. The battle is mostly in the air. Their infantry can't do anything to stop us. We have a numerical advantage in infantry as well. But of course their planes would have slaughtered our infantry, so we needed to have a numerical advantage in planes as well. There are some vanilla buildings still, militia barracks and such. That's because this is a Russian town with the German buildings, and that's why they don't have the German custom buildings for barracks, etc. If we fight the battle of a German town like Stettin or Berlin, they will have custom barracks, etc. So our planes are now taking care of their infantry. Their general is here. He will die soon. There he died. He still have some planes in the air. Enemy general fallen, Nikolai Ivanov. Willing capture. Alright. Their infantry have reached the plaza. That is huge. We have a jeep entering as well. Driving over our own troops there. What do they have over here? Stokes mortar. It's firing. the Soviets still have some planes, I think. And there... not many. They seem to be defeated. 13%, 91%, yes. Clear victory this time. The Jeep bodyguard is in the at the center. Has reached the center of the city. We have taken the plaza. Here we have a Catholic church, Jesus. We have winter terrain outside of the city. So the war during winter of 1942 has started. Fast forward, I don't have time with this. I wonder where they have troops still. Ah, I see now. They have a plane over there. They went out and took care of the Stokes mortar and controlled by the AI. Now they return, they have two MiG-3s. Now they are fighting the planes again. Of course they're not gonna win, they have two planes against all of our planes. We don't need to continue the battle, end game. Alright, so Gunther Alterbung had 79 men, killed 0, men remaining 68. That was bad. Gottfried Galen, 537 men, killed 89, 454 remaining. Nikola Ivanov died, he had 98 men, he killed 103, that's pretty good, and 9 remaining. Alright. Once more a red fire blows deeply upwards. The factory will do no more work for Herr Churchill. Tomorrow morning, Coventry will lie in smoke and ruins. Joseph Goebbels, Minister of Propaganda, September 1940. Didn't crash, good. Exterminate population, of course, we don't have revolts. Don't need any buildings that are from Soviet, let's destroy them. Stable Soviet. Even the airstrip will be destroyed because it's a Soviet one. Right, we have Brest in Polish town. Are there any Soviet buildings here? No. And we won't destroy anything. Because if there are Soviet buildings still standing, then that means the settlement is more likely to revolt. Can't merge, all the units will merge the infantry. Assault infantry. And stuff. Right, let's move them into the city. Our general died. Heroic death, Gottfried Galen. As expected, one general died. Minsk has fallen to the German Reich. So we have one army inside of Minsk. We have managed to reconquer. Ignored Riga because I didn't want to waste Erwin Rommel's army there. Need to move the spy now. Let's move her to Kiev to get some idea of what is going on over there. We have great forces marching here. Tanks. Your great arm here, it will move towards Kiev in 2 turns. In 3 turns they will be in Kiev. Goal of Ernst Dissel is to take Kiev. That's a mechanized army. I want it to face actual armies. We will send a third army towards Kiev, an army with mostly infantry. Actually, we might send this army towards Kiev now. We need to hold city. They have planes outside. Even more units here. They might want try to retake the city. Or they might actually attack Rome. We will see what they will do. We won't do anything more this time. We might need to repair some stuff. The west wall could be repaired, and yeah, I think that's it. And then the cobblestone road would be good. And that's it. Next time. Britain has attacked my fleet of U-boats with the diplomat on it. Not good. So they have black swan ships, and they have a hood. This is the same fleet that probably destroyed us previously. Let's retreat. We can't retreat. Navies cannot withdraw from battles. Alright, automatically resolve the battle. Clear defeat. We might have lost them there, or they managed to retreat somewhere. We will see. No one attacked besides Britain. War declared on ally by Hungary and Romania. I'm tired on that Hungary faction constantly declaring war on everyone. Let's do this. So, we are at war with Hungary, and now we will try to force them into being more peaceful by making them a protectorate. Also, you are allowed to help with the Soviet Union. Only faction you should attack. Hopefully as a vassal they won't start a lot of wars against my allies. So now Hungary is a vassal of the German Reich. End of turn report. Still plus in profit. Repair complete. The West Wall has been repaired in Minsk. Recruitment report, we have assault infantry in Vienna, Copenhagen and Oslo. Diplomatic information, the following factions are now at war with each other. Hungary declared war on Romania, the British Commonwealth of Nations declared war on Hungary, Turkey declared war on Romania, following factions have broken their alliances, People's Republic of China has broken their alliance with the Chinese Republic, the following factions have declared a ceasefire, French Republic and Hungary have a ceasefire. Lions and Tatters, Hungary and the Third Reich. War. The Third Reich has declared war on Hungary because they declared war on Romania, which is an ally. Lions announced, Hungary and the Third Reich. Ceasefire in effect, Hungary and Romania. As a consequence of the alliance with us. And then we have created a client kingdom. So, as we can see, Hungary is now a protectorate of the Reich. And are not independent anymore because they couldn't handle that without declaring war on everyone around them. They even declared war on Germany in the past. Let's attack the Soviet fleet, clear victory, and blockade their port. It is still winter. here. It's stronger now. Under General Nikita Stalin, family member. They have 4 MiG-3 planes. They have some SLT infantry and riflemen. General has an armored officer's car, so it's a good general. Alright. Won't attack currently. We have a greater army here. Lots of planes, including MiG-3s and tanks and infantry. Wonder how many planes. They seem to have started to focus on planes. I may need to switch focus to from panzers to planes soon. Because they are starting to look dangerous there. But I wanted to focus on tanks and stuff. So I could get the tigers and such. But I also want most factions to first, most settlements to first have all the infantry and artillery. And then the tanks and then the planes. They have entered Poland with a unit here. 3 units. Probably planes. So we are marching towards their troops there. They have 2 Stokes mortars and 1 unit of MiG-3s. Right, and the army. We will leave 4 units of riflemen as usual. And the panzers will roll on towards Brest. Stokes mortar there. General back to München. Doesn't have a general, so it's good for it to get one. Assault infantry unit could be moved towards the front. A unit of BMW motorcycles will be sent towards the front as well. Panzer 4 sent to Brest. So we leave 4 infantry units. If we have 8 units left, we can send there. 1, 2. I don't want to send the SLT infantry there. 3. Four units with this one. All the troops, see if the ship survived. I don't think so. Check this scroll. So we have any, should have 1 fleet at least. Lost the diplomat and the ships. It didn't reach Africa. Too bad. It was a mistake to fight that navy battle. The naval battle there. USSR diplomat in our lands. Turkey and into Africa. Soviets have a great fleet here, but they can't move it out of this bay. That wasn't a great fleet. We have a bigger one somewhere. So we have a spy. Let's take a look at their stuff over here. Kharkov. Stalino. We started with those areas too. Kursk was held by Hungary. Kharkov by Italy. And Stalino by us. We also held this area. Smolensk. We need to hold all of these areas to get back to where we started. And then we are good to start the real campaign against Soviet. Alright. So we have full army here. Scare away that force. Can't leave the settlement currently. We will wait on more soldiers. Well, this army. Good attack. We have the same number of planes, but we have better planes. Alright, and yeah, I think we're good. Save the game. Fight the battle on the battlefield. Erwin Rommel saw me. Heavy casualties inflicted on the enemy have greatly affected his morale and will prove to be a turning point in the Battle of the Atlantic. Admiral Sir Max Horton, May 1943, commander of the Eastern Approaches. Still winter. Start deployment. And we are in a forested area. With Rommel's army arriving in the Winter War. Close to Leningrad. So he has a tank army, but it's an old army that moved from Africa. He has Panzer IVs. He actually only has one Panzer IV unit. Then he has 5 units of Panzer I's, 4 units of Messerschmitt 109 planes, 3 units of Africa Corp Assault Infantry units, 2 units of PAC 40 artillery, and 3 units of BMW motorcycles. And Rommel himself could be in the back. He has a bodyguard of Tiger I's. So Tiger bodyguard, not King Tiger, but Tiger. They are pretty good. 12:31, 10:50. Nice. All right. So Rommel has finally reached the battlefield. So the artillery will be one group. They will be a loose formation and will also have one line, I think. And the BMW motorcycle shouldn't be part of that group. And they will then they will have fired wheel. Fired wheel from here, from mountainous position. PAC 40 is there. And then the army could be AI controlled actually. Because we are facing such small forces. there. Some infantry. And their planes. Pack forties have already started to fire. Our panzer force are moving forward there. Good position. Not a bad map for artillery. Rommel's tank army, or panzer army, is moving forward. It also has some BMW motorcycle corps. Mechanized corps. Panzer force are driving forward. There are mostly old, outdated tanks in this army. This is the first battle of Erwin Rommel in a very long time. Since the Battle of Benghazi, on the second episode, I believe. He also fled in a battle, I believe. No, it wasn't him, it was another army of Tunisia. So they had lots of planes. That's what makes me worried. Actually, I want to know where my planes are. The idiots. They seem to be idiots. Let's move them out of the army. And now let's manually order them to attack their planes. I don't want their planes to take out my tanks. So I needed to manually order my planes to take care of their planes before they do that. Alright, now they should move. Because my panzers are at disadvantage. And my BMW motorcycles. Great tanks, great panzers would be all slaughtered by those planes. They had a lot of planes. The BMW motorcycle units are moving up there. What the fuck are you doing? I told them to charge the planes. Usually they never listen after you have let them be controlled by the AI. That was a mistake. I shouldn't have let the planes be controlled by the AI. Lose all my tanks now because my planes didn't show up in time. What are they doing? Idiots. I might replay this battle because I didn't like how incompetent they were. They are retreating with their general. They still felt that they were at a disadvantage here. My tanks easily scared away their infantry. Their planes, where did they go? They all shot down. seem to have retreated their plane. So we won this battle. Great job, soldiers. Shame they took out a lot of our poor tanks because we didn't send out our planes in time. So Erwin Rommel had 540 men, killed 220, have 488 left, lost mostly tanks. And the enemy Nikita Stalin had 361 men, killed 58, mostly tanks, and have 136 left. Alright. I like the winter battlefields. On this 10th day of June 1940, the hand that held the dagger has struck it into the back of its neighbor, Franklin Roosevelt, on the Italian declaration of war on France and Britain, June 10th, 1940. Didn't crash, I almost thought it would crash there. It took a long time. So Rommel won. We won't merge any units. We need to take out armies. We don't move such an army towards some infantry. We need to take out something better. So let's move him towards Captain Dimitri, whatever he has. Another army. Here we can fight the battle. But yeah, let's do this. I don't like. Yeah, let's see. We will simply send out one unit of riflemen. Save the game. This way the entire army could be easily controlled by the AI from the start, so they do a better job. And because that's such a small army, we don't need to micromanage it. I speak in the name of the entire German people when I assure the world that we all share the honest wish to eliminate the enmity that brings far more costs than any possible benefits. Hitler, 14th October 1933. Alright. So we have a rifleman unit, loose formation, start the battle. Let's retreat the rifleman unit. Planes have already reached the battlefield. Stuka bombers here. And some Messerschmitts too. Here comes tanks. It's a huge army. Panzers. Constructed recently. Fresh units. And a jeep bodyguard. Planes and tanks. Equal number of Panzer IVs and Panzer I's, I believe. Arriving at the scene of the battle. I wish they had more heavier tanks already, but historically they got Tiger I's in 1942. Didn't have a lot of them, maybe. A great tank battle at Kursk was in 1943, so reinforcement earns this one. Yeah. where the enemy has 2 units of Stokes mortar and 1 unit of planes. MiG-3 planes. Tanks have reached the enemy, they will just steamroll the Stokes mortars, but the planes are still dangerous, but we have a total numerical advantage. We just need our planes to reach their planes. Tanks will easily handle the artillery. So that's no problem for them. Panzer IVs are pretty cool. Tigers are obviously even better. Panzer I's are heavily outdated, but still better than their MS1s. Rest of the forces are far behind the great line here of tanks. First Panzer Army has arrived. Even some BMVs. Look at the sky, it's kinda green. General's dead, enemy general Fuller and Captain Kirill. They didn't have a real general in this battle. Alright, so this was a clear victory. Force moving forward here. Onwards to victory. To end siege. Which means final victory in German. So their mortars are still firing, they aren't entirely defeated yet. Reforming. Their planes should be upon them soon. Trim isn't fought some Panzer I's first and not the planes. They took them out with the planes. Now our Stukas have reached their planes. Problem is they are tactical bombers. Here are the fighters. We have some Panzer IVs moving. The others. Right. Balance of power, 6% allies killed, 64% enemies killed, victory seems certain, only fool could lose this battle. Yeah, we just need to take care of that MiG-3 unit, and they have lost. Mortar unit here is routing, they're broken. They still have the MiG-3 in the air, which is a problem. They took down a few of our tanks. Even Panzer IV there. And it wouldn't surprise me if they take down some Stukas too. So we won the battle! Great job, soldiers. 75% enemies killed, 6% allies killed. So, Captain Alfred, 60 men deployed, killed 1, 60 remaining. Ernst Diesel had 476 men, killed 54, 448 remaining. Captain Kirill, 73, killed 30. Mostly tanks. Alright, 17 remaining. Detailed statistics. Your task will not be an easy one. Your enemy is well trained, well equipped, and battle hardened. He'll fight savagely. General Dwight Eisenhower, 6 June 1944. Yes, didn't crash. Got the man of the hour, too. It's a new general. Alright. And we got the new general for the one unit there. Let's return them to Brest, maybe. We can continue the march with this army. We have a Stokes mortar unit there. This army could head for that area of Kiev. See here, we will send the BMW motorcycle unit there. Then we will send some Panzer Ones. Move this general back to Brest. Right. So it will soon enter that army. All right. This army could move the next time. And we have a diplomat in Spain. No, we moved it. We have a diplomat in outside of Helsinki and the diplomat here, right? And let's take a look at the building and the recruitment now. One turn left until we have the heavy tank factory. Good. Will enable us to construct Panzer Ones from Berlin. In 1942, hopefully. It will be historically correct. So let's see if we can construct anything from somewhere. No, we couldn't. We are already constructing in most places. Let's check the recruitment and construction. Alright, in Oslo we can get another assault infantry unit. And we are already recruiting or constructing in most places. In Brest we can get an assault infantry. In Vienna as well. And in Copenhagen. And we're back in Berlin. Alright, there isn't much left to do. Let's just click next turn, I think. Yes. Portugal is attacking Bordax, a neutral faction, an allied faction too, but it was a dictatorship, as I said before. Rioting in Minsk, they are rioting even to get exterminated their population. Fuckers. Anyway, let's move this tank inside of that army. I don't like when that happens. Take a look at the city. Let's retrain some units there. Small concern. Public order. We need something like that. Civil headquarters is needed. Alright, we'll build it next turn there. army could attack Kiev, I believe. Minor city. We are blocked by an army. So Ernst Diesel is blocked. They might actually attack us next turn by combining their forces. They had many smaller forces here. Many scattered into many smaller groups. Alright, rioting in Minsk, rioting in Brest. Settlement besiege Bordeaux. End of turn report. Marriage celebrations, Felix Battle, Emily. Construction report. In Berlin we have a tank factory now, which will enable us to get the Tigers. Tiger ones. Bordeaux have a medium concern, and Wars have a medium concern. Recruitment report. We have new stuff. New Panzer IVs, SLT Infantry, Panzer ones. Stukas and Messerschmitts, 109. Fighters, alright. Diplomatic information. The following factions are now at war with each other. Bulgaria has declared war on Turkey. The British Commonwealth of Nations have declared war on Turkey. Portugal has declared war on the Third Reich. French Republic has declared war on Hungary. Following factions have declared that they are allies. Chinese Republic and the People's Republic of China. Following factions have declared a ceasefire. People's Republic of China and the United Soviet Socialist Republics of the Soviet Union. Alright. Need to check Brest. Let's repair stuff here. And retrain the riflemen. Here we have some diplomats. Romania, Bulgaria, Hungary, Bulgaria. Here's my diplomat, isn't that a diplomat? Dear. Good, we are here now. Portugal here. Actually, they are neutral, so we can't stop them from having a... Can't use total diplomacy with their diplomacy. There's some British ships here, including a good fleet. We have French here as well. So this army is besieged. They have some troops as well. Their leader, family member, took Smort or Hurricane planes, probably better than ours from Britain. Riflemen, right. Send a plane unit there as well. Stuka plane. Much we can do besides that. Tanks have arrived here. BMW motorcycles. Pressed. General back, another unit of panzers will enter into Brest. We move army. I think we will move two units of riflemen to Warsaw. We don't need a lot of riflemen, some panzers depressed. And the rest of the infantry. Let's move this unit towards Stettin. So Hungary might actually want to attack us. Let's move the assault infantry towards Warsaw. Stokes mortar too. General here moves into München. So in Rouen, I guess we can move this tank unit down there. We don't need a lot of other units there. Half an army in Bordeaux. If that army can even partake in the battle, I'm not sure. Alright, in München we have another Panzer IV. Let's move it towards the front. Prague Panzer IV as well. Move it towards the front. And in Stettin. And in Berlin too. I believe in Hamburg we might have something new as well. Panzer I. Panzer IV in Frankfurt. Smith 109 fighter in Amsterdam. And that's it, I believe. Alright, now the recruitment and constructing. Big concern in Berlin. Let's be a training ground. I think we'll go for the big concern. Alright, and in Bordeaux we won't build anything right now because we are under siege. In Warsaw, I think we'll go for the large caserne. We're back in Berlin. Now the recruitment and constructing. Alright, so now we have access to the Tiger I tank. We compare them, 13 melee attack, 19 missile, and 10 charge bonus, 25 total defense. 19 missile, 10 charge. Okay, Panzer IV, 25 missile, same 13 melee, 10 charge, 30 defense, 25 and 30, and 19, 25. Alright, and then Tiger 13 and 10 in melee and charge, it's the same. Missile 32 instead of 25, and also 51 in total defense. Plus, they have the much better Barrel 1 cruiser projectile. So, let's construct. Let's see here, 120,000 for Panzer 1, 285,000. Panzer 4, 620,000 for the Tiger 1, Let's construct the Tiger One in Berlin. In Hamburg we will construct another Panzer One. In Oslo we'll get some Assault Infantry. In München we'll get another Panzer IV. Frankfurt will get another Panzer IV. Amsterdam will get another Messerschmitt 109 fighter plane. Brussels will get another Panzer I. Paris will get another Stuka tactical bomber. Rouen will get a Panzer I. Bordeaux, we won't do anything because they are under siege. Warsaw will get a Panzer I. Vienna will get an assault infantry unit, and in Prague we'll get a Panzer IV. Stettin will get a Panzer IV. Copenhagen will get an assault infantry unit. We're back in Berlin. Take a look at this fleet here. Yeah, we will siege them, siege the port, block the port. And now as for our generals. Minsk is very unstable. Let's see here, I hate revolts. When I play this, the rebels, that they will revolt a lot, so we need to do this. Minsk. Alright, and let's just see what this is good for. For the order. Public order. Small park could be built there as well. Hopefully they won't revolt. Brest. Hopefully these guys won't revolt either. Alright, so we built a construction cobblestone road in Minsk, civil headquarters in Minsk, a small park in Minsk, and in Brest we got a repair for a town, and the east wall was repaired. So now it's only the military. So they had quite a force. Far away. See. I think we'll let them attack this time. All right. Next time. Didn't attack. Writing continues in Minsk and Brest. End of turn report. Still plus. Construction report. We have a mortar training ground in Rouen. We have a mortar training ground in Amsterdam. And we have a big concern in Paris. Recruitment report. We have new assault infantry in Vienna, Copenhagen, Oslo and Minsk. Diplomatic information. The following factions are now at war with each other. League of Nations, the French Republic and the United States of America have declared war on Turkey, a neutral faction. Following factions have declared that they are allies. The Japanese Empire and India has become allied. Hungary has become an ally of Turkey. The following factions have declared a ceasefire. Bulgaria and the British Commonwealth of Nations. Hungary and the British Commonwealth of Nations. Alright. Turkey is now entirely in the war. Seem to have made enemies of the allies as well. So we have an enemy here. Mostly infantry units. Let's move towards Smolensk maybe. Maybe I want to crush that army. They were attacked on their way there. Not good. Just auto-resolve that one. Can't reach them, alright. Back. So we already have such. We need a Stokes. We need a Stuka there. Bomber. Move down there. All right. They're in normal counterattack this time. Full army here. We'll fight that battle for sure. Start the battle actually. One army versus one army. Fight the battle on the battle map. I'm sending mobile troops out tonight. Not possible to hold tomorrow. We'll resist to the last man and last round. Major General Henrik Klopper, commander of the Tobruk garrison, to General Ritchie, 21st June 1942. Start deployment. The general's bodyguard will be moved back, of course. Don't want him to partake in the battle. Army will fight without him. Great tank army entering the battle here. With planes too. Facing a great Soviet army on the other side with lots of planes. They might have the advantage in planes actually. They had lots of infantry too. And almost no tanks. Probably no tanks. They had some tanks. T-34s. Or even might even be better than T-34s. I'm not sure. We'll see how this battle will go. We are mostly tanks and they are mostly planes, so we could lose. It will be their vengeance after we took out many of their pants, but their tank armies with planes. They would do the same to us now. So our panzers are moving onwards on the battlefields. In Ukrainian lands. I believe we are close to Kyiv. Yeah, they have an advantage because they have plane advantage. They had some BMW motorcycles as well. Shame that they focused on planes and not on tanks. I wanted a great tank battle. Might be too late now. Might only spam planes. And that means that our tanks will be crushed by the airplanes. Yeah, there are lots of planes here. Right. So in late 1942, Soviet has a lot of modern planes in the air. Dangerous, huh? Their infantry is easily crushed and routed already. One unit is still firing here, wounded. We aren't entirely without planes still. I think this went pretty well. I didn't want to waste them on planes, unfortunately. I had no choice there. Sometimes they are matched against the wrong type of arm. Balance of power. Allies 41% killed, 7% enemies killed. Defeat is a distinct possibility, yes. Zoom in on the minimap there. Would have been so epic to face their tanks with our tanks. But it might be too late. Now they have planes instead. Right, we'll continue to build the other buildings and make the planes last. We'll give the AI an advantage. They like the challenge. So. Clearly losing this battle. 53% dead, 9% of theirs. So the faction with the air superiority is clearly winning. Bad. This was a fresh army with new tanks and everything. Mostly early tanks like Panzer 1s and Panzer 4s too. But even the best tanks are weaker than the planes, so... So I will only use the cheat when I have almost a revolt and need public order. Then I will cheat so I get the public order buildings, because I hate having to retake areas that should, you know, be mine. This mod didn't have finished, you know, public order stuff. I believe the possibility for settlements to revolt is pretty high. Even if you have exterminated the population, they will still revolt. So you need to have public order buildings in any non-German areas, especially enemies like Russia. And they won this battle. They took out most of the tanks, not all of them. Killed, 42% enemies killed. Had they won this battle? Did the same to us as we did to their tank armies. Let's fast forward, the battle is lost. Now it's just a matter of them shooting down our final stuff. Oh, we only have the general! I need to retreat my general. They probably are still fighting in planes there. I will retreat the general. He survived the battle. Alright, he was the only one left. He didn't kill anyone, he had 22 men. Captain Ferdinand had 292 men, killed 310, that was very good. Had 40 left. And enemy army Captain Alexander had 722 men, lost 220, killed 227, had 403 left. Alright, and the detailed statistics screen. So, that was the battle. They won thanks to their air superiority. An entire army of tanks couldn't stop that. As they said, the enemy knows that he must wipe out our fighters. Once he has done that, he will be able to play football with the German people. Field Marshal Erhard Milch, 1943. Didn't crash, good. They need to go eat, I think. So that was the end of that army. So move her back, the spy. We have lost this entire front. All the armies have almost been destroyed. We have a great army in Minsk. They need to stay there to keep the population from revolting. One unit there. We have a great army under Erwin Rommel here. He can't move this time. I had wanted to move this army, but now they need to keep the order in Minsk. Actually, everything that gives us public order will be built, because I don't want revolt. Minsk might still revolt. Stokes mortar. We are far from done this turn. One general should probably move back. Move him to Brest. Brest is also revolting. Ready. Our Panzer Army. Almost ready. Let's merge those infantry units. 2, 3, 4, 5. I have Stokes mortars. Let's move on inside the city instead. Unit there, a panzer, and another one. Move that unit inside of that city, and the riflemen to Brest. The panzer unit to the army, and move it there. So Gunter Alterbung is ready with a new army. Mostly tanks, some planes. They had a lot of planes there. I'd like another army to face that army. This army had more planes. This is a T-34-85. Yeah, it looked better. Can't see the stats. It's better than the T-34. It's pretty good. They've gotten their T-34-85s now. Let's move this army towards Stedden. The planes there. Moving towards the front. Thanks. British Commonwealth of Nations. I wanted to speak to them for a long time. Berlin. Unfortunately, can't do that from there. Unfortunately, building everywhere. We lost that diplomat. It was in Spain. Too bad. We'll move down towards Britain and France. They are closer. All right, and we'll see if Portugal will invade. I mean, attack the next turn. They have already invaded. They haven't attacked yet. Assaulted, I mean, the city. All right, we're done here. All right. Don't know if we have built everything. I think so. We will check to be sure. No, we didn't. Amsterdam. Let's get this. See here. Howitzer training ground. Yeah, let's get the howitzer training ground. Yeah, Paris too. We'll get that before we get the higher level of tanks. And the mortar training ground here. Small concern in Minsk. Rest, we can't build anything. Mortar. Okay. Back in Berlin, recruitment. We're still constructing the Tiger One there. Assault infantry will be trained in Oslo. And in Bordeaux, we will get another Panzer One. In Minsk, we could get a spy. And in Vienna we could get an assault infantry unit. And in Copenhagen. And we're back in Berlin. We're done. Next time. They attacked us. We have 34 men. They attacked with 3. Let's retreat. Portugal, they're off the ceasefire. No, you attacked us. Can't just let them have a ceasefire when they attacked us out of nowhere. We have a new general in Warsaw. Let's move him to Stettin. And this general could move to Hamburg. Alright. Didn't like your surprise attack. They are still attacking like that. So their army, they have 4 units of riflemen, 2 units of Stokes mortar, 1 unit of grenadiers, they have 1 unit of scout snipers, 2 units of Fiat 3000 tanks, and the bodyguard of armored officers, car bodyguard, alright. Of course we're gonna attack. Fight the battle on the battle map. Against the Portuguese invader! That attacked Bordeaux, a French occupied area. St- start deployment. It's winter here too. We have modern roads. Nice. Alright. Start the battle. Pause the game. Send our tanks, our panzers against their panzers. We have two Panzer ones. They are still better than their Fiat 3000. Alright, we will send our bombers against their fighter planes, but their fighters are actually better than our bombers. And then we will send a Waffen SS infantry unit against their infantry unit here. Their grenadier unit. And they had an additional unit there, but we have an entire army coming, mostly infantry, coming from Bordeaux with more planes. We'll see how this battle goes. We might lose. Reinforcement, Captain Joseph. He probably had hidden units. Yeah. They have snipers. They are jeeps. Stokes mortars. So Portugal is in full action now. They are old Italian constructed tanks. They have the Italian flag, the tank. They are bought from Italy, probably. Historically, Portugal had such tanks, but I added them to them because they didn't have any tanks in the game. The Panzer Ones have arrived here. The additional ones. They have no chance against their Hurricane planes that Portugal bought from Britain. Entire unit of Panzer Ones taken out, two maybe. Tanks lose planes. The Waffen SS unit is also broken. They won easily against the First Army. Heroic death, Captain Gottfried died. Alright, but the real army is arriving now. Some more Panzer Ones and Stuka tactical bombers. They also have at least one unit of Messerschmitt 109 fighter planes, so we should be able to win now. They had lots of infantry. Mostly riflemen, some assault infantry too, I believe. Maybe one sniper unit as well. Even an SS unit there. I just thought that all factions should have tanks, that's why I gave the worst Italian tanks to Portugal. They had such tanks in real history. Right. So the army seemed to have passed, waiting for the rest to form a line before continuing the march. Have any of the Nazi planes reached the enemy? I wonder. No. They haven't. Alright. So the balance of power is very equal. Evenly matched. Allies 11% killed. Enemies 8% killed. So they lead in the percentage rating. We have more troops. But they have some better troops compared to us. Mostly better troops. We have good planes too. Portugal invaded the border with France that Spain has. I wonder how they could move right through Spain. Ah, now the army is moving. We have a Pennsylvania unit there as well. So garrisons in this border is not as strong, but better than no garrison. Portugal isn't as strong either. So now we are in total war with Portugal. We'll have to move through Spain. We get to their capital of Lisbon. They have some cool unique units. Grenadiers here. I believe some factions have them, like the United States has them as well, but with different skins. Mostly riflemen here. I wonder if I had any assault infantry. I'm not sure. Doesn't look like it. Only the Waffen SS unit. Otherwise, riflemen. Yeah. So the basic troops. They will probably be shot down pretty fast by their hurricane fighters. I want the Messerschmitt 109 planes to go face those hurricanes. Let's take a look at them. 228-31 experience 2. Ours are better because they have higher experience, higher combat experience. Ah, the battle has started. The planes have started to fire at each other. They have very long range. The rest of the army just seem to look at each other from afar, look at the distance. This campaign has become really fun, I guess. I think it's really fun now. It's like we are advancing. I just don't want all the settlements to rebel. If they do, I will probably use the auto-win to, as soon as possible, reconquer them. I don't count the rebels as a real challenge. I only want to face, you know, other playable factions, not the rebels. In real life, they could imprison civilians in concentration camps and exterminate them. Which means rebels shouldn't be a problem for any modern faction with modern weapons. However, the other powers are a problem, of course. Not the civilians that are revolting. And I don't think they would show up like armed, like gangs out of nowhere. And after they have exterminated their population. So, anyway, It's annoying to replace stuff all the time. I know when I played as the rebels that they revolted all the time, constantly. I like the modern roads here. It makes it look more modern. Finally the infantry is moving as well, and the tanks. Forward soldiers, onward soldiers, those Portuguese. They need to be taught a lesson. They can't just declare war and invade a superior power without being severely punished for it, thinking they could get a ceasefire immediately when we sent some troops to reinforce our border, which they didn't expect us to do, thinking we were too busy in the east, so they could just grab Bordeaux from us. Closing in their army. So they are leading the statistics to 17% ally skill, 60% enemy skill. Portugal. The planes have started to shoot down our Stuka tactical bombers. They thought they wouldn't stand much chance against the hurricanes. They probably all be shot down. Yes. There they have their cars. Armored officer's car. Our Messerschmitt 109 fighters will probably win against their fighters, hopefully. If we lose this battle, Bordeaux is lost. Then we will send more armies their way. We are defending here, but we are defending French territory from Portugal. French territory that we occupied before the campaign started. Taken in 1940. The game started in 1942. The infantry has started to fire and being fired at. Right, so we'll see who win this. We'll win infantry against infantry now, I think. Portuguese infantry, riflemen. Let's check their stats. So 5735 is their stats. Then we have 5738. So our infantry has better defense, otherwise it's the same stats. They move forward their tanks now. Their light tanks. The Fiat 3000s, Italian tanks. They bought from Italy. These cars also have machine guns. They shoot from the window. Yeah, like that. Their planes are still in the air. They've scared away some of our infantry units already, made them rout. The infantry can't win on their own. They've taken down the Stuka tactical bombers. Where are the Messerschmitt 109 fighters? Here we have one of them. Should be able to win, I hope. If they lose, the battle is over. And Bordeaux will fall to Portugal. Because we failed to defend it. They are winning. 65% allies killed, 32% enemies killed. Their planes were better than ours. As far as I can tell. Oh, their tanks have now started to drive over our infantry. Routing over there. Not good. Seems to be a clear victory for Portugal. Germany will lose the southernmost region of France. If France betrays us, we will force them to become a vassal, because they were a vassal historically. But hopefully they won't betray us. Portugal was neutral, so they will be a real challenger. We need to defeat them. Or lose against them. We lost the battle. Alright. So Captain Gottfried had 113 men killed, 15 lost at 7 really bad due to their planes. Captain Joseph had 587 men killed, 159 lost, have 96 left. David de Mello of Portugal had 513 men. Killed 558, 341 left. They did a really good job, the Portuguese. Alright, the detailed statistics and return to the campaign. It didn't crash. And now we have failed to defeat the Portuguese. They have their army still intact, while our reinforcing army is defeated, and the defenders of Bordeaux are now reduced to 3 units of riflemen. The town is lost. Fortunately, we can't have that. Wait a second, could I send something there? Hold up. not over. Send reinforcements from Paris and Rouen. I might have sent too few reinforcements there previously. But that could be easily fixed. The infantry are too far away. And I don't think the planes can reach from Amsterdam. Alright, end of turn report. We are still plus. Fashion announcements. Alright. Construction complete. In Frankfurt we have the SS headquarters, so we can recruit spies from there. Recruitment report. In Berlin we have a Tiger 1. In Frankfurt we have Panzer 4. In Vienna we have Assault Infantry. In München we have Panzer 4. Hamburg we have Panzer 1. In Copenhagen we have Assault Infantry. In Oslo we have Assault Infantry. In Rouen we have Panzer 1. In Amsterdam we have Messerschmitt. In Paris we have Stuka. In Brussels we have Panzer 1. In Prague we have Panzer 4. Warsaw we have Panzer 1. Stettin Panzer 4. In Minsk we have a spy. Diplomatic information. The following facts are now at war with each other. British Commonwealth of Nations have declared war on Hungary, Bulgaria and India. The following factions have declared a ceasefire, the Italian Empire and the French Republic. They fled. Those bastards. Alright, let's merge the infantry. We can't move anymore. We can't move more this time. So we have to wait with that. They retreated and I tried to sally out. They didn't take products. I didn't want to destroy the buildings. We have a small tank factory, port, medium caserne, etc, etc. It's a town. Large town, actually. It's pretty big. Alright, there are more to do before we can click next turn. We have this front against the Soviet Union, too. The Soviets have sent an army into Romania. 6 units in that unit. Or in that army. Army sent into Kiev. Planes and tanks. Problem is they might have a lot of planes. We have mostly tanks, they are panzers. But a lot of Panzer 4s. Some Panzer 1s too. Shame they don't have a lot of T-34s left. Would have been cool to have tanks versus tanks. Anyway. Let's move these troops in. I didn't have a infantry unit there. Alright. Good. The revolt was stopped in... No, it's not stopped, but almost. We have a green guy at least. Send tanks there. Submerge the infantry again. Force will be sent to Warsaw. Assault infantry will be sent to Warsaw as well. This could be also sent to Warsaw. Don't have anything to send in. Krag, Norrenstetten, Panzer One, Tiger One to send. But I don't want to send Tiger Ones yet. I want more of them. I can send all the early tanks too, like the Panzer Ones and Force if I have that. Unit of Messmith 109s will be sent there too. Panzer Force from Frankfurt. Some Panzer Force from München. So, in Amsterdam we don't have any tanks. In Brussels we do not have that either. Alright, we're done with the movement. It's time to look at the construction. Again. In Frankfurt we could build an aerodrome. It will enable us to build Messerschmitt, Stukas and U-88 bombers. Heavy bombers. I believe that's the new unit, so we will build that. Alright. I'm surprised the game hasn't crashed yet, and I played a lot. But I need to go eat, so I can't continue too much longer. Alright, we didn't have any more areas to build from. But we can already build or construct the next Tiger One tank. We'll do that, and more Panzer Ones, Assault Infantry in Oslo, Panzer Force in München, Frankfurt, we want Panzer Force, in Amsterdam I could actually use some Messerschmitt 109 fighter planes, and in Brussels I need some Stuka tactical bombers. Paris, I could use some Stuka tactical bombers, and in Rouen we could use some Messerschmitt 109 fighter planes. Minsk, we could actually use more spies. In Warsaw, we could get another Panzer One. In Vienna, we will get another assault infantry. Prague will get a Panzer IV. Instead, in a Panzer IV. Assault infantry in Copenhagen. We're back in Berlin. Let's now take a look at the agents again. Also, Adolf Hitler is in Berlin. He can't move out of there. He's locked to his capital. The same is true for all the other heroes or leaders or whatever you wanna call them. So Hitler will stay in Berlin until he is killed in Berlin. Same is true for Stalin, who will stay in Moscow, etc, etc. Alright, yeah. Spy, she will stay here. Yeah. Erich Becker, spy. So spies have male names, but they are not men. We send her down there so we can see what's going on there. Alright, and I guess she will stay there. I need to be able to see what's going on. Alright, diplomat in outside of Helsinki will not do anything currently. Let's go to the French Republic. French Republic, they are an enemy. So we will only get map information.
Left click on an item in the proposal to remove it. A balanced or very generous treaty proposal.
Got a lot of information of actual areas in Africa now. Portugal.
Left click on the list of
new enemy.
Items to create a proposal.
Map information there. generous treaty proposal. Some new information as well there. And then the British Commonwealth. We want their map information as well. We'll give them ours.
Left click on an item in the proposal to remove it. A balanced or very generous treaty.
Good.
Proposal.
Most of the map became visible now. Britain has huge areas in Africa, as has Portugal and France. They have Australia. They have Canada. Statue of Liberty is here. Alright, we have areas in India too. They are still holding areas there. And areas down here, taken from, probably from Thailand or something. What about the areas down here? Japanese are down there. Yeah, you need to speak to the United States of America. They are far away, they are all the way over here. We need to go to Tunis to speak to them. Zoom in on the minimap. This is Africa. Most of it is controlled by the Allies. Right, armies could still move. Minsk and Kyiv is still contested territory. But then after that, we have need to get a new army together. The problem is if they have a lot of planes in their new armies, then our tank armies or panzer armies might be at a disadvantage. Alright, next turn. We are attacking Minsk. We had an army there. Sergei Ivanov, 1,105 men. He had lots of planes and infantry. Let's take a look at the general, Sergei Ivanov. Starting general with a bodyguard of riflemen. The other one, Igor Girich, family member. He might have an armored officer's car, yes, he's a real general. Then they had lots of riflemen, the assaulty infantry, one unit of assaulty infantry, one unit of tanks, MS-1 tanks, the light tanks of the Soviet Union. And they have 6 units of MiG-3s, their best fighters. They have no bombers, so... Alright, we also have planes and stuff. let's save the battle, let's save the game before the battle. So, and I will have to stop here because I need to go eat. Alright, see you soon. Hello, Victor Nygren here, I'm back. So we are going to continue. We are defending Minsk as Germany. And the Soviet Union is attacking. They have this force here with lots of planes. It will be very equal. Their infantry isn't that dangerous, but they have more infantry than we have. And they have more planes. So we will see how this will go. If we lose, we only have Erwin Rommel here. And another tank army here. If those three armies fall, then they will be able to march all the way to Brest. We are building another force, but I believe it's not ready. And we might actually lose Poland. And of course we have some infantry armies, etc. in Germany, but then we need to start constructing planes as well as tanks, and not just tanks, because I believe we need armies that have half the army consisting of planes and the other half being tanks. It's no fun if they are only planes, made up of planes. It will be too easy, but it's not possible to have only tanks either, because Soviet has started to field a lot of planes, and tanks cannot win against planes if they are too many. Alright, let's start the Battle of Minsk. Fight the battle on the battle map. Oh merciful Lord, crown our effort with victory and give us faith in the inevitable power of light over darkness, of justice over evil and brutal force, of the cross of Christ over the fascist swastika. So be it. Amen. Sergei, Archbishop of Moscow, 27th November 1941. It's winter still. We are defending Minsk. Start deployment. We have a large town here. Houses, Catholic Church, civil headquarters that we had to build to prevent the revolt. We used the sheet to build that fast. Same with the airstrip here. So an airstrip here now. The most basic form of plane. Airfield, I mean. The thing is, it also increased the public order in the city, and I was desperate for public order. Otherwise it would have revolted. Can't have revolts if we can prevent. Alright. This is a large town, I think. Or town. Any other custom buildings? Mostly houses, it would seem. Alright. And the army. Let's place the general at the center. And we could place some mortars here as well. Loose formation and fire at will. Loose formation, fire at will. As for the rest, let's group the rest as their own units. And loose formation, guard mode. And let's place them under AI control. Alright, start the battle. Here we have the Soviet Union and their army. Lots of infantry. Also lots of tanks. And they have some jeeps there. And MS-1 light tanks. They're just steamrolling the city there. There are planes entering. However, the bunkers took out some of the planes. They are inside of the east wall. They didn't bother to take out the defenses. Some of their planes have already reached the center. So there are fighting going on at the center. And the deep bodyguard here too. I've added him to the AI control units. Seem to have taken out the mortars. My bodyguard has gone out to fight against their light tanks here. Stand much of a chance there against the tanks. Mortars are abandoned because they're crewmen. They're kind of crushed. One of them seems to be reforming. So there is a dogfight in the sky above Minsk. Capital of Belorussia. They have some infantry on the outskirts of the city. But most of their army haven't entered yet. They're still standing outside. They have the jeeps here with a red star. And their general. And their second general there. Starting general. His assault infantry unit has gone into the city. Building lost. See what we can do. Let's place all of them in like this. And I need to find one of their units. So we can properly counterattack. I don't want any of the units just standing still. Oh, there's a demon now firing. Their essence rifles there. The air battle in the sky is still raging on. The balance of power is clearly on the side of the Soviet Union. Percentage allies killed 20%, percentage enemies killed 11%. So it seems like they might win this battle. They had an advantage in planes, number of planes, and in number of infantry. Thank you. general, he doesn't have a weapon. It's the only jeep left. I think. Let's move him to the center. He just moved right through here. They still have planes in the sky above here, so he's still in danger. I wonder why most of their infantry are standing outside of the city or town. And not inside. Yeah, we need more armies with a mix of planes and tanks, and not one of not like only tanks, and not only planes, but both. And we don't really want infantry. They could be in cities defending to keep public order. But they aren't really needed in the armies. They are so easily defeated that it's a waste to recruit them. Chaos on the streets of Minsk. The Germans are overrun by Soviet soldiers. The Stuka tactical bombers there are dropping bombs on their infantry. One went down there because their MiG-3 fighter plane showed up there and shot it down from the sky. Doesn't look good for the Germans here. The infantry of the Soviet Union started to enter the city en masse. Stuka bombers are dropping bombs on them. Some assault infantry there. It's very evenly matched this battle now. 37% allies killed, 28% enemies killed. Eeps have entered too. Their machine guns. Alright. We are starting to lead in the balance meter. 3%, 34%. It's not certain we will win yet. Our troops have been weakened by the revolt in the city. Might win actually. They're retreating with their bodyguard. Is that the general too? No, it's just the driver. Only jeep left there. The general is dead. Enemy general fallen. Igor Girich is dead. The battle in the sky is still raging. We will see if we can win. It looks like it though. 41% allies killed, 42% enemies killed. They are being bombed from the sky by the Stuka tactical bombers there. These are also being bombed. The terror from the sky is raining down upon them. Still have some MiG trees in the air. I don't know if they can actually turn the battle around or not. I don't think so. I think we will win this battle. Infantry versus infantry in a melee fight here. Rifleman versus rifleman. They clearly had a numerical advantage here. But our tactical bombers have reduced their numbers.
Der feindliche General flieht! Hat keine Ehre!
Street fighting. From building to building. All right. Our general is still alive. They somehow missed to fire at him. Missed out on the general. Stokes mortar unit here. Crewman. Their infantry is now routing. On every front there. We seem to have won this battle. Because we won in the sky. They still have some planes left. Sky scout snipers here running around. Percent 69% kill. All right, so this battle is almost over. Let's fast forward. We have won this battle. There's no point waiting. That fast forwarding, we want it to be over as soon as possible. Airfield, the airstrip. Lot of dead bodies here. Their infantry is now running from the city. Stuka bombers are bombing them as they run away. It's a shame they can't bomb the buildings. But now we are holding them, so it doesn't matter. Alright. So you don't have a lot of infantry left after the battle. We will have to merge the infantry units. This was an entire army destroyed here. One of the three armies. All right, the battle is over. Became very smoky, smoke right from nowhere. Can't hardly see anything now. Cool. Like if the city is on fire and there is smoke and stuff, then you would hardly be able to see anything in the smoke. Now the weather became clear again. So this Stokes mortar is firing missiles now. Again. Alright, so the Soviets might still have more armies to send our way. We can't handle another invasion of similar caliber. So yeah, we need more planes, but also more tanks. We need to make the armies better, more balanced. Because if we lose these three armies, Rommel's army and this army and the third, the Panzer army, then we only have Saki garrisons in Germany left. Infantry garrisons with a few planes and tanks. Here we have a small concern. Small concern. And it's over, end the battle. So Ernst Dissel had 348 men deployed and killed 938, that was very good. And remained 149, he lost about half. Sergei Ivanov had 1105 men killed, 175, really bad. 152 men remaining, so it was really bad of the Soviet army. We'll see if it will crash now. I'd like to play the Japanese later, and the Italians, and the United States. That would be cool. Maybe even the Soviet Union. But I believe the Japanese first. Yeah, didn't crash good. End of turn report, we are still plus, going plus in the economy. Construction complete in Minsk, we have a small concern. Yeah, I saw that in the battle. Recruitment report in Vienna, we have assault infantry, and we have assault infantry in Oslo and Copenhagen as well. And then we have a spy in Minsk. And diplomatic information, the following factions are now at war with each other. Portugal has declared war on French state Vichy. People's Republic of China has declared war on the United Soviet Socialist Republics or the Soviet Union. The French Republic has declared war on the Italian Empire. And the following factions have broken their alliances, the Soviet Union and the Chinese Republic. So the Chinese Republic chose the alliance with the People's Republic of China, the communists in China, over the Soviet Union. And then the following factions have declared a ceasefire. Turkey and Romania, Bulgaria and the United States of America, the French Republic and Bulgaria. Alright. So they have three MiG-3 units there. So now we have a better view here. Seems Romania is safe from Turkey. Bulgaria are still holding those areas and Hungary these areas. See. But Turkey has taken Tirana. No, allied. It's written allied here. And I'm not allied with Turkey. At least I don't think so. No, they are neutral. That means an ally has taken that area. Alright, let's move the diplomat into Africa. Wonder what the Soviet Union is doing in Romania. We won't move that diplomat. But in Minsk we have a new spy. We will merge the infantry too. We had very few assault infantry units left after the battle. Hardly a unit. Two snipers. Could disband them. We don't need two. Alright. We also lost one of the Stokes mortar units. Minsk. We are sending out some additional troops to Minsk. Right. 14 left. Let's disband. Move some tanks and planes there. And additional tanks. Actually, we could move this army to Minsk. So we have a Soviet army here, pretty big army. What we need is we need some of the planes moved. Alright, can't move the Stokes mortar. So two Messerschmitt 109 fighters there. We only have two of them here, or we have one actually. Let's move some fighters there. Some Panzer Ones to this army. So we have five planes here and five planes there. That's good. Need some planes in that force. And of course I want the Stokes mortar to be moved there. Let's move these to Brest. So we can't move. Move them all the way to the Minsk settlement yet. Right. We have a Romanian army here. So they have they've got scout snipers, they have some riflemen, cavalry. Pack 40 German artillery piece or gun. Alright, in Brest we place those units, yes. We won't move the general there. Can move an assault infantry unit towards Warsaw. And a plane unit from Stettin. Smith 109 fighter plane. Tiger 1 could actually be moved towards Warsaw. Hamburg. Could need them closer to the front. Those planes. Infantry only in these areas. Almost only infantry. Alright, Hamburg. Five units of assault infantry, we don't need that. Disband. Alright, and in Amsterdam we will keep everything. In Bristol we could probably move one unit of assault infantry. All right. So I think we'll move most of this army towards Portugal. So they fled again. Too bad. I want to fight the Portuguese army again. Alright. fight the battle on the battlefield. People die, but books never die. Franklin D. Roosevelt, 23rd April, 1942. Start deployment. The new army at the Spanish border has been assembled, mostly Saki infantry again. But with some planes that this time around. I did a mistake and didn't move out enough troops. Could have had a huge army if we had moved out all of these together with the other army that were defeated by the Portuguese. Then we would have crushed them. But I thought I could have defeated them with that force. Now I just sent out everything we could. Alright. Let's group the infantry into one group. With loose formation, and then we will group the tanks into one group. Put them in loose formation as well. We have two units of light tanks, Panzer 1s. Then we have four units of Stuka bombers and three units of Messerschmitt 109 fighters as one group. Start the battle. We are reinforced by one unit of German riflemen. So not much of a reinforcement army. Alright, the enemy is over here. So we will order the infantry first. We will attack the air infantry. The riflemen, of course. We'll attack the air riflemen. We only had one rifleman unit, so the other was an... We had two assault infantry units. They attacked their... They will attack their riflemen units. Alright. And they had a sniper unit. We don't have any snipers. Send the Waffen-SS to handle the snipers. And then we have another assault infantry unit that will handle this unit of grenadiers. And I believe we could send another SS unit against the snipers too. Alright, and then the tanks. Of course we will send one unit of Panzer 1s against their Fiat 3000 tanks. And the other one will be sent towards their Jeep bodyguard. I mean their armored officer's car. And then we have the planes, of course. We'll send the Messerschmitt 109 fighters against their planes first of all, as they are more suitable to fight planes. So that's three planes. Did they have more in the air? I don't think so, but they might. We have some bombers. One of them will bomb their Stokes mortar unit. Another one will actually bomb their tanks. And the third one could bomb their armored officer's car. And the fourth one could actually bomb this unit over here of Stokes mortars. Alright, start the battle. So we had no general this time. The plane is a general there. So our planes are already arriving. The goal here. Messerschmitt and the Stukas. This time I hope they won't win. Mortars are trying to fire there. They are being blitzed. So all my units were ordered to attack without mercy. Even the tanks have arrived, driving over their troops there. So now it's payback, because they dare to win against the first army that tried to stop them. Their poor grenadiers and riflemen being bombed from the air. They had far too few planes to handle us this time around. Still have some planes too. They've already defeated most of their land army. The planes are still in the air. Alright. Here are their scout snipers. Here's a tank still standing. They had more than one tank still standing. They are being bombed from there. Good job, planes. I hope you can take care of the airplanes before they shoot you down from the sky. So the balance of power, 10% allies kill, 86% enemies kill, victory seems certain, only a full release battle. Yeah, they still have an officer's car here, armored officer's car, but it didn't look much very armored. Yeah, and there their general died. David de Mello of Portugal is dead. Fire 3,000 Italian tanks still running around there. Great victory. So how many have we killed? 96%. So let's continue battle anyway. We want to obliterate them. We won the battle now. Clear victory! Captain York. Man deployed 417. Kills 313. Very good. 377 remaining. Captain Walter 30. Rifleman kills 0. Men remaining 30. David de Mello, the enemy army, 325 men, 30 kills, 11 remaining. Really bad this time of Portugal. Alright, a shame we need to go through Spain in order to kill off Portugal. We might provoke Spain into invading us if we walk on their territory with an army. That's what I'm worried about. Could take the fleet there, but then the British fleet might intervene. Peace in our time. Neville Chamberlain's beach in Heston Airport. Alright. The man of the hour. We got a new general. Let's merge the units here. So we have an ally here. Rifleman of the French state. Which, if you are on Spanish soil, they are an ally as well, because otherwise they would declare war. Alright. We want to take Lisbon. Lisboa, the Portugal of capital. The capital of Portugal, I mean. Yeah. Alright. So, what now? We have the Soviet Union there. We have much of an army. We have some planes. Not a full army. Here there might be almost a full army there. can't move there. Alright, a battle with Erwin Rommel. We will not control Erwin Rommel himself. I mean, he will not be part of the big army. We will control him so he isn't killed. Alright, their army, by the way, consists of only riflemen. It will be an easy victory. We will still fight on the battlefield.